Okay, so we're here today to essentially to lend our support to the people of Venezuela, to the government of Venezuela, because the Venezuelan people had elections on the 14th of April, and they democratically elected Nicolás Maduro as the president. He won with 51% of the vote. However, the opposition candidate refused to accept his defeat, and instead of giving his speech accepting his defeat, he actually called on some of the most violent supporters of his to take to the streets in a rampage that resulted in 8 people dead, as well as the destruction of some health clinics, some political party offices, and in injuring many other people. So we are here because the media in Canada and in the rest of the world has been incredibly, mysteriously silent on what has gone on in Venezuela. And there are, I think, many people in Canada who follow what's happening in Venezuela who are deeply concerned about the situation there, and they feel that the government of Canada, Stephen Harper, who claims to be a Democrat, should acknowledge, recognize the government of Venezuela to help bring, again, stability into the country and so that they can move forward with their electoral process.
We are here in solidarity with the Bolivarian Revolution, and we are here to demand that the results of the election in Venezuela that happened last Sunday to be respected by Canada and by the United States, the only two countries that to this moment they have not accepted the results of the elections over there. The Bolivarian Revolution in Venezuela has brought healthcare, education, and housing to millions of people, and this has to be supported. During the presidency of Hugo Chavez Frias, poverty went down, and now Nicolas Maduro has committed himself to continue this process. And the opposition that is denying the results of the elections do not want nothing but going back to the oligarchic system, which left millions and millions of Venezuelans in poverty. So we are here in solidarity with the Bolivarian Revolution and to demand respect the results of the election.
And Bolivarian, the name Bolivarian comes from Simón Bolívar, who was the leader against the Spanish conquistadores many centuries ago. When President Chavez, Hugo Rafael Chavez Frias, that was his complete name and last names, when he implemented a Venezuelan type of socialism with his reforms, he improved people's life. He improved health conditions, and he also improved housing conditions and education conditions for the Venezuelan people. Third, President Chavez always fought, he did fight against oppression forces that had kept Latin American countries, most of them, in poverty. What forces are those? Mostly the US imperialistic forces. Second, the NATO forces in the alliance with the US, forces that denied the possibility for the Latin American countries to develop to its full. And since President Chavez died about a month and a half ago, we are now celebrating that his successor, President Maduro, who also was elected by a majority of votes about a week ago, we are supporting President Maduro, Nicolás Maduro in Venezuela, as the legitimate, legal, and popular elected president in Venezuela, and we are asking foreign forces, mostly the US, not to intervene in Venezuela, to respect Venezuelans' rights to self-sovereignty and self-determination, and to allow the Venezuelan government, the Chavista government in the head of Presidente Maduro, and the Venezuelan and Bolivarian people to continue with their reforms for a most peaceful, progressive, and happy life for most Venezuelans.
Since last Sunday, the opposition forces attacked healthcare centers that are being run by Cuban internationalist doctors. They set one of them on fire and they killed 8 supporters of Hugo Chavez. So this is the result of the work of the opposition while they are crying foul about the results of the elections, but they are causing violence and through terrorist activities they want to overturn the results of the election. That's why we want the international community to condemn the opposition forces and support the results of the election with the presidency of Nicolas Maduro.
Nosotros aquí, un grupo de venezolanos, latinoamericanos y canadienses, venimos a expresar el apoyo y la solidaridad con el pueblo venezolano que el pasado 14 de abril eligió por mayoría al presidente Nicolás Maduro para continuar la revolución bolivariana. Muchas gracias.